Then start thinking about what you will feel in the next time zone of today.
Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters!
This is a journey into sound.
The fattest, funkiest tunes in town.
Now, here comes the music.
You got a beat for me?
This one's explosive.
All right. Hello, everybody. How you doing tonight? I am super excited for tonight's show. And without further ado, let's invite our co-host, the one and only Ashley, I'm doing it again. Veda Ashley and Bobby Shadow, everybody. How
That's
you
very
doing?
Very militant of you to address me by my surname, sir.
I'm so sorry.
It's Where's quite Bobby? All right. No, I kind of liked it. I know my face isn't showing it, but that's nothing
Bobby.
Bobby.
Where is Bobby? Hello. Hello, Bobby.
Is he at CVS where? Again?
I hope not. I thought he got everything out of there. Well, you know what? There he is. Bobby Shadow. Everybody in the chat.
Where in the world is Bobby
Shadow? In the world is Bobby Shadow? So everybody in the chat, if you know the location of Bobby Shadow, I want you to put it in the chat. And guess what? If you are right, you will win a prize. But until we figure out where he is, filling in tonight for Bobby Shadow.
You already got a fill-in?
Yes, of course.
Jesus,
I do.
You work fast, Mr. Nemest.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Oh, and incidentally, I love your new headset and microphone, just saying. But without further ado, the one, the only, Vegan Dough, everybody.
What?
Oh my God.
Hello.
Oh my God. Look at you. You look amazing.
Thank you so much.
Oh my God. I've never been starstruck before, but I think I'm getting starstruck just looking
you
at
haven't?
You. That you're the sexiest before, Freddy Krueger I've ever seen in my life. Wow.
I'll take that as a compliment, I guess. Thanks.
Well, how are you doing, you two?
I'm doing great.
Yeah.
How's everyone else?
Oh, I'm doing wonderful. You guys have not been together in how long now?
It's been
a stream?
So long.
It's been a few months. It's not all right.
It's not all right.
No. So this was a shock. What the heck?
Yeah, right, what the heck, right? This. Ooh, we got to put
no,
you on
No, no one informed me that Bobby Shadow would not show up again and this would be the replacement.
You know, where in the world is Bobby Shadow? I need you in the chat to help us out. I mean, where in the world is Shadow? I mean, but you know what? Really, I am so excited about, for tonight's wild card guest, and it's going to be an amazing show. And vegan dough. Wow.
Dough vegan.
Yes.
Dyslexia.
Can we call you? Dough Krueger tonight, or what should we call you?
I mean, it seems appropriate.
I think it does seem appropriate.
Yeah.
Wow. So what's in? Wow. Can we ask you how long does it take you to get that look?
Well, I made all this just with stuff I had laying around the house because I didn't have time to like.
Oh, just random stuff laying around the house.
So yeah, I literally made this entire glove.
Only in Doland do you have all that.
And that's this right. Makeup took me about 3 hours. I really needed probably like another hour or two, but it took 3 hours.
That is amazing. 2 or 3 hours. Oh my God.
I'm stunned.
That is so amazing. And let's get a shout
the
out
chat
to
likes
the chat.
It. Look at
yeah, the chat
shocked.
Loves it. Yes.
Hi, everybody. How are you? Is this Elizabeth? Who F is Elizabeth, Jenny? Bruno?
Tony, Danny, Kevin, the Mead.
Oh, Mark Gage.
Mark
woke
Gage
up.
Is here. Oh, he woke up. He's
Good
here.
Good morning,
Stevie.
Mark.
Hi,
Stevie
Mark.
Wonder.
Hey, Kevin.
Thank you for all the hearts. Debeth. Debeth is here. Thank you guys
Wait
for supporting.
Wait a minute. Another handcuff. No, someone's got scissors for their hands.
Yes.
It's actually like my right hand as well, which makes getting into this broadcast difficult.
Wait, what made you decide to do it with the right?
I think that's the one he has, right?
Oh, is you it? Literally went straight up method. Yes. That's nice. I like that.
Nice. I
would attention like that. To detail. Only a Virgo.
Exactly. Thank you for the heart bomb.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you for the heart bomb. And do you know that, I don't know if you guys know, but tonight's special guest, Rodney Eastman.
Knows.
Are you guys excited about?
I'm very excited.
Yeah, and he's going to be reunited with you. I don't know. He's going to probably be like,
wait to see him again.
They're I old know, friends. Right? They're old friends. They are old friends.
From what
they
era? Are.
Oh, from way back. From way back.
90s, 80s. How far back are we talking? Gen Z might be in the audience. They don't know a thing. I'm sorry.
Oh, that's true. You know, you got to keep me up on that. I forget. I use my daughter too to kind of help me out with that kind of
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, like use her as a frame of reference. What you do and don't know.
Exactly. That's exactly. Smart. Yeah, exactly.
Doe never fails to surprise.
Thank you, Danny Bruno.
Me neither.
But you know, kind of on the theme tonight, the horror theme and everything like that. Do you guys remember when we were collaborating to do this and we wanted to do that one kind of crazy video of us three? Remember that?
Was I actually there in
you
my
were
body
so
and spirit?
There. You were so there. And unfortunately, I was there because I think I'm the one that lost my head. Here we go. Pull up in a monster, automobile gangster, with a bad bitch that came from Sri Lanka. Yeah, I'm in a tanka, color of Willy Wonka. You could be the king, but what?
Ew.
Like I said, I think I got the short end of the deal on that one. That is my head, unfortunately.
A decapitation.
You wow. did. You decapitated me. What did I do? What did I do?
Cage.
No, you know, that's the funny thing about the movies is you never know what role you're going to get. Is that right, though?
Well, usually you audition for the one you're going to get, but like, I guess, yeah, there can always be a change.
In this new age, everything is changing with technology, and sometimes you just get put into roles and you wake up and you don't realize it. Like this one horror movie that us three were in. You remember this one?
Don't ever talk with your eyes.
Now you are a vampire.
You're dead, you're dead, you're dead. You're dead and out of
oh, that one. Jeez.
Remember that one?
No, well, I tried to forget about it.
See, Doe is the shapeshifter, and there she shifted into a kitty cat. Look at that.
Meow. Meow.
It was a fun role.
Oh, no, it is.
Oh,
and you know,
liked
so.
It?
We are all enjoying ourselves here on HAPS, right? We're having a good time.
Shout out to the Network of Now.
The Network of Now, that's right. Shout out to the Network of Now. But also, we also want to let people know that there is this contest going on, right? And you got to get in the queue.
Oh, yes, guys. Get
that's
in your
right.
submissions. Come on.
Get your
chop,
submissions
chop.
Into the queue. Get in the queue because you know what? You still have time, everybody. There is still time to get into the queue.
Who's in it? Do we know? Are we allowed to say? Is Mark Gage in the queue? Because if so, count me in.
You know, I think he is, but you know, I think we're gonna wait to like say who is exactly in the queue. We want to give people opportunities to get in the queue because until the show ends, you can win a prize, but you cannot win a prize unless you are in the queue. So everybody, please sign up right now. Sign up. So,
yeah,
Ashley. Why don't you know what? I'm doing that again. Remember the first show? Was it the first show? How many times did I call you Ashley?
I wasn't paying attention. I usually block that out, but I don't know, like maybe four times. So now it's
maybe
six.
Maybe four times. Four, six. Who's counting? Who's counting?
I mean, it wouldn't be a first. I'm honestly, I answer to both, but just don't tell the internet.
That's true. That's true.
All right.
So, you know, since we do have the lovely Doe with us, you know what would be a nice opportunity? Is to perhaps
turn yourself on.
Ooh.
Are you ready?
Marina, you shouldn't have.
Yes. I know. I know.
God, I should have done one of her meditations before this broadcast.
That might have been a good idea.
Yeah. I did one on Sunday, actually. One that I've done several times before. I woke up and I felt like I needed to do episode 18, which is the one about responding rather than reacting. And I didn't know why. I was just called to do it. And then that night I was hit with a situation where because I had listened to that, I was able to respond. and not react.
Very good.
And I saw myself out.
I'm willing to bet that episode 18, mm-hmm. the learning to respond instead of react in situations, I bet you some people at the Oscars probably should have watched that episode before they started. Just saying.
I mean,
anyways.
Possibly.
Possibly.
Might have helped.
But just in case you don't know, we'd love to promote her, Marina J. This is one of her best-selling books, Turn Yourself On.
Yeah.
We highly, highly recommend it. So,
I blacked out for a second, but yes, all of that, yes.
I know.
Have some tea.
speaking of blacked out, what is the beverage of choice tonight?
Tonight I have a green tea, and someone in my stream on Twitch, follow me on Twitch, guys. That's gross, yes. But do it. It suggested that I add in a bag of ginger as well, and I did that. It made the green tea much nicer. Yeah, I'm on an anti-inflammatory diet for a lot of things. Yeah, Doe started that first, and I was like begrudgingly knowing I needed to handle my inflammation issues. You guys, we all have inflammation, by the way.
Exactly.
If you're a human. But I'm on day 4, I think, and by day 2, I was already feeling better. So it's
a
quick result situation. I mean, with my gut, not necessarily with my arthritis, but you know, it's enough to keep me going. So
I just saw Danny in the chat wants to know how you join the queue. Is there a link?
Oh, yes. So Danny, I am so glad that you asked. So it's simple. You just go to FanQuest Live app at your app store and you sign up and then you put in the code 22 and guess what? Just like that, you're in the queue. So you got to get in there before the end of the show and you will have a chance to win a prize.
18 and older only, please. Thank you.
That's true. 18 and older. Only 18 and older. Look, she's showing it right there.
Oh, thank you, Doe. I mean, wait, what should we?
It's Doe Kruger? Is that what
Kruger.
We're going with?
Kruger. Kruger Doe.
I don't know.
Credo.
Kruger Doe? That sounds
delicious.
I'm just
going to say Sir Crudeau, if that's all right.
Sir Crudeau. Ooh, I like that. Sir Crudeau.
Oh,
Sir Crudeau. Sir Crudeau, is it difficult?
Mark Gage got in the queue last night.
Yes, he did. So, Sir Crudeau, is it difficult to drink with that makeup on? Or do you have to use a straw? Or how do you?
No, I can drink.
Yeah.
I just, with a bottle, just. You know,
just la bottle. She's just like,
gently bottle.
I just
want to
make
water.
Sure that you're hydrated for the show. You know,
that's
3.5 hours seems very long. There we go. All right. I want to make sure that's good. All right, cool. And guess what? When you do enter in the queue before the end of the show, if you're not already in the queue at FanQuest Live, as soon as we end the show, we end the queue at the end of the show, you will know immediately. It'll pop up in a notification. You are the winner. So.
Oh.
Oh, nice.
Yes. So good you're gonna know. Everyone. You're gonna know instantaneously, pretty much.
Good luck.
Good luck.
I have to be honest. I've never actually seen the film, so I don't. Does he speak? I don't know how he speaks.
Freddy Krueger. How does he speak?
I'm a wimp. So even doing this makeup was freaking myself out. So.
Was it?
Yes.
Do you know the funny thing about it?
I haven't seen it either, but to be able to do that and not have seen it is impressive.
So I think there's 3 horror movies that are my top 3, and it's The Nightmare on Elm Street, the Jason series, and the Michael Myers series. The difference between the 3 are Michael Myers and Jason don't speak. Freddy does. Freddy Krueger has like a sense of humor as he's slaying you, right? So he'll say some like comedic line as he's clawing you up and doing all, you know, doing his dirty on you.
Stevie
you know what I'm
Wonder
saying?
Is attesting to that. Wow.
Yes, he does. Oh, yes, he does. Doe doesn't like the horror movies. You know, a lot of people don't.
Baby, like an actual baby.
Yeah, my wife doesn't like the horror movies either. I have to watch them with my daughter does, which is interesting. So my daughter and I will watch them, but not my wife. She's like, nope. Shout out to Leslie. How you doing, Leslie?
Wildcard has a message for you, Mr. Demist.
Ooh.
Hey, Leslie.
Yes. Yes, I see that. Oh, that's cool. Absolutely. Absolutely.
I was communicating with Kruger, I thought.
You know, I can communicate with him too. We can do a double. That one's on a higher note. I think that's the A for the third eye chakra.
Hi, Leslie. Welcome to the broadcast.
Does that kind of set your...
That was nice.
Set your mind right.
Oh, is that what he says, Danny Bruno? Okay.
Yes, that is what he says.
Okay.
Freddie is my worst nightmare. But which one in the chat? Put your favorite. If you did watch the series, what is your favorite Freddy one? I'm just curious if people have particular
ones. You guys
ones.
Deliberate that. Give me 1 second, please.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Uh-oh. Somebody dropped their drink, I believe. I've almost been afraid of Freddy.
Much, Leslie. It's just me. It's just don't.
It's just me. I still can't believe how amazing you look. Like, wow.
I've never done Freddy before, so this was a challenge. So thank you for suggesting.
And you did that off a photo or a video when you do that?
Yeah, a photo.
Oh my God. And that's all by yourself. No help.
Yeah.
You're so amazing. Oh my God, you're so amazing. I could just imagine the amount of different characters you can do.
I know, it's so much fun. That's like the best thing. You can be anyone.
And so when you get out of costume, is that like mm-hmm. Do you go in the shower and it's just like a it's just makeup everywhere, or do you do it in the sink and kind of get off the initial mess
and then the shower? Yeah.
And then the shower.
Are we talking about the aftermath?
Yeah, the aftermath.
I did have a bowl cut.
Think about that.
See,
I'm into that.
And I was mm-hmm. gonna do all that, but the one I got was actually latex and I'm allergic. So I put it on, I was like, no, this isn't gonna end well. So
no, do they have an alternative to latex when it comes to
Yeah, I think you can get like silicone or something.
Silicone
maybe.
Ones?
Yeah. Yeah. But I didn't realize the one I had was latex, so
Right, right.
Good thing you did.
Silicone.
I know.
Veda, you're familiar with silicone, right?
Oh yeah. I got to. I mean, are you actually asking me this, or is this like
no,
a shtick?
It could be a shtick, or maybe
I have some silicone in my suitcase that was in my body.
Oh, I thought it was in your freezer. That was in your.
Well,
freezer.
It was in my freezer until I didn't no longer have a freezer. But they'll be back in my freezer next week.
Nice.
So
nice.
For now, I carry them. They're very prized possessions.
And I'm super excited for that. I cannot wait to see your new setup.
Oh, I know. Exciting. Me too. I can't even. It has not hit me yet, but I have the same.
Yeah.
How long to go till the move?
I start my drive, I believe, next Monday. So probably will have to have a stand-in for next week. Who wants to? Mr. Bruno? Just kidding.
Mr. Bruno. We might need another stand-in because you know that happens. Life happens, and sometimes you have to have fill-ins.
Sometimes,
especially when you get caught in traffic on the freeway, you know.
Oh, we have a traffic situation.
Possibly.
Yeah.
You lived in LA before, right? Veda, I almost did.
Yeah, but I don't want to say what I'm going to say because it won't help this case. I always plan for traffic when I'm living in LA. I never was late.
You don't want me to say that. No, I know.
I'm sorry, I have no filter. I'm not.
I got to say though, when I look at
I'm never late. I'm always early.
I know. When I look at tape on the traffic in LA, I'm like, how do people get anywhere?
You
going
plan
up
for
and down
it.
The
it never is the. It's never.
Yeah, but how do you plan in the
reliable.
Gridlock? I've seen where they're just stopped. And like,
you give
just,
yourself
not...
2 hours to go 20 minutes, and you know that usually 2 miles takes at least 20.
See, even Del
two
was
miles
rolling
takes
her eyes
20
like,
minutes.
Like, no, I couldn't. I no.
I couldn't do that.
Two hours to go 20 minutes. I just
or you
not
stick
going
to
anywhere.
Your.
I would walk.
You stick
I
to really, your hood.
You know, I take
you,
my bike.
You move where you live, or you stick to your neighborhood in LA. But yeah, 2 miles is usually 20 minutes.
Well, that's also a shout out to hover cars that are not that far out in the distant future for us. And that's going to eliminate a lot of traffic gridlock.
What about sky crashes?
Well, you know, there's always that.
Come I mean, even planes have traffic. Have you ever sat on the tarmac for like 2 hours?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, they have, they're actually, if you've seen it, if you want to get serious about it, they actually,
I do.
they have the different altitudes for the different, you know, for the vehicles, including the drones. When we start having drones delivering packages and stuff, they're going to have their own airspace as well. But yeah, I mean, like anything, there's going to be a logistics issue that's going to have to be resolved. But you can't stop the future and you can't stop technology. Change is constant. It's constantly coming. You either accept it or you get wiped out by it.
Ooh.
So I'd also like to know, wiped out. Left behind is a better word for that. I'd like to know if anybody in the chat, remember, we still have that ongoing contest for the name of the show. Who ever puts in the name that we pick, you will win a prize.
When are you picking the name?
What's the prize? Tell me what the prize is so I know if I want to enter.
All right, I'll tell you what the prize is. All right, you got to promise. You got to promise not to tell anybody, though, and I'll tell you what the prize is. All right.
Oh, that's an amazing prize. I got it telepathically.
Oh, see? I told you.
And I already forgot. So don't ask me.
All right, hold on a second. Bink, bink. I'm just doing a little quick re-invite because sometimes there's a little bit of technical difficulties.
I just want to stare while we're doing that, for a second. Can I see the hand up close?
Do you guys want to listen to a little bit of music?
Look at the blood on it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we want to listen to music.
Okay, I want to test the volume.
Look at the craftsmanship of that hand, you guys. Is it people taking this in?
Now listen to this music. Is it too loud? Is it too low? Can you kind of get a little bit of the lyrics?
It's a little low right now.
I can't really hear it.
All right, hold on. How about now?
That's good, I think.
So right there, I'm going to test the levels before Rodney gets here.
Oh,
how's it? Is it too loud? Is it too low? How's this?
It sounds good. Okay to me.
Okay, so in the chat too, can you hear the music? Can you hear the lyrics? Is it just right? You can hear us and the music? Perfect, perfect. All right, perfect. All right, we'll get some tunes going. I'm getting excited. I feel like Rodney's close. Rodney is close. Do you sense him? Do you sense him in the distance? He's getting closer.
I mean, I have goosebumps. Is that Rodney? Rodney?
It possibly could be. It's maybe a little hard to hear, but hear the music. All right, I don't want to overwhelm it too much.
And you know what? Starbucks.
Shout out to anybody who can guess the band of the music that I am currently playing. I mean, you're going to get some bonus points on that one if you can actually guess that one. So, are you guys ready? Are you guys ready for our special guest?
Yes.
You ready?
I'm so ready.
I am too. I am one too. Let's get him up here. The one and only.
Survivor of LA traffic.
That's right. Survivor of LA traffic. The one and only. Rodney Eastman, everybody.
Woo.
Hello, Rodney.
I look like a hippie.
Wow, look at you.
Sorry, I just got off the golf course and out of LA traffic. It's been tough.
You made it.
Hey, wait. Before we start, do you mind if I first shout out to some special friends in the fan queue?
Absolutely.
Okay, so Rick Costa, how's it going, buddy? Tony D, High Roller, Sweet P Leslie, are you out there? Truly Gene, Hapsaholic, What?
Who dat?
Good Karma, Haps, and of course, the illustrious Stevie Wonder.
Hello, ooh. Stevie.
We got Vada Ashley, isn't that you?
That's me, yes.
Crooked Muse, Ash Pauls, and Anapop 18.
Nice.
I made it!
Nice!
Awesome.
Give them a round
of applause. Thank you for being here.
Oh, thank you for having me.
course.
Absolutely. We're so excited to have you here on haps.co, the network of now. And incidentally, how did you shoot today? What was your score, if you don't mind telling us?
I'm a longtime golfer, but it doesn't show really in my score. But I did shoot a 93, and that's pretty good for me.
You know what? That's great. Amazing, because when I'm also a fellow longtime golfer, but when I shoot under 100, that's a good day. That's a good day.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes, but if I'm playing for money, my handicap is a 22, just saying.
Yeah, if I'm playing for money, I'm about a 36 handicap.
All right, we can go. All right, 44.
Are you guys
Hold on, I'm going to switch chairs.
Okay. Sure, do what you need to do. On. Absolutely.
All right.
So, you know, do you know, Rodney, when a couple things that I want people to realize, because when I found out that you were going to be on our guest, a special guest, I started looking up you and kind of your bio, and you're born and raised in Canada, but then you moved to Montebello, California at the age of 5. And when I read that, Montebello, California, it was like, I'm like, Montebello, I grew up on Monticello, and I had a dog named Bello. And if you don't know, Bello in Italy or in Italian is beautiful. So
that's right.
I don't know. It's just the way my brain works, a little bit weird.
You're a poet.
I'm a poet, and I didn't know it.
Well, I think you know it. False modesty is not cute. Come on.
No, but I think you
that
are modest.
That man modest?
Because you, right out of the chute, at the age of 5, you already knew you wanted to be a movie star, didn't you?
I did. And it's funny. I was actually just talking to... Oh, can we have a big round of applause for Miss Angela Monzon?
Absolutely.
My lovely wife.
Round of applause.
Yes, Angela.
Set up our little home studio here. And thank you. Thank you, honey.
Yes. But
we were just talking about that. The Oscars this year. Wow. I mean, I'm sure everyone's heard enough about it. But
why? Did something happen?
Yeah.
Other than the awards?
Yeah. There's some kerfuffle. I don't know. But it's really interesting because, and not just the Academy Awards, but just sort of TMZ culture. I don't think if that same 5-year-old kid that I was back in, if I was a little kid now, I'm not so sure that I would want to be an actor.
You know,
when I watched the Academy Awards when I was a little kid, it was very distinguished and low-key. You didn't know.
It was exciting.
And you didn't know every single thing about the actors and celebrities. Right. And there was a mystery about everything. And and that was really enticing and really interesting, you know, as a kid. And that just doesn't exist anymore. And when Nightmare on Elm Street came out, it was in the top 10 films of that year. Nightmare on Elm Street 3 and 4. And and I was famous and I didn't even know it. So like that
kind
was
kind of like I'm a poet and I didn't know it, you know. Kind of
there you go.
Thing.
That's right. Yeah. Monticello, the home of Thomas Jefferson.
Yeah. No, but you're so right, exactly, Rodney, on that, Rodney, because I remember even as a child when it would run long even back then, and your parents would let you stay up late, and it was like a treat because it's like, they didn't say the best picture yet, I got to stay up. You know?
I had my notebook out, and I wrote down everything, and I would bring it to school the next day. No one cared about it but me, but I was like, look, the Academy Awards were on last night.
Yeah.
But, like, the access to celebrity these days with the internet has just, like, kind of killed the... You know,
there's no one yearning
to see it. There's you already have instant access to go on their Instagram. So,
no, but you know, back to your movies, I couldn't believe that you actually were in like 40 movies, you know? That's amazing. Yeah. And like some of the movies I know that some people will remember was, of course, A Nightmare on Elm Street. You were in 3 and 4. The Dream Master, Deadly Weapon, Mobsters, and the opposite of Sex. And then you came back for Freddy versus Jason, right?
A little cameo in that one.
Right, but that's fun when they do that.
And then also there was I Spit on Your Grave. The first remake, which I'm very proud of. You know, I think it's a really... I think I've been in some of the greatest horror films of all time, but not many. And but I really think that I Spit on Your Grave is a really, really incredible, hard to watch film, but really well done. Really proud of that one.
And a lot of people don't realize too that you were in 54 different television appearances. When I was looking that up, I was like, you're in 54. And you were in Baywatch with Tracy Bingham, right? Do you remember the name of the role that you played in there?
I don't.
But of course not, because they didn't give you a name. You were listed as the teenager. That was a trick question, though. But that's funny though, because you were also in one of my favorite TV shows, X-Files. You were in Monk. I love The Monk. Mm-hmm. That was a fun show. I used to watch that with my wife a lot. The Mentalist, I used to watch that with my wife a lot.
Love it.
And then Murder, She Wrote. There is a classic.
That's right. And Highway to Heaven also.
Yeah, true. Highway to Heaven. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep. Absolutely.
So yeah, I feel like I've always been pretty humble around my career and, you know, living in Hollywood, there's so many people that have that have done, you know, 2 shampoo commercials and you know, they boast about it, and you know, I use their celebrity to their advantage, and maybe I could have done a better job at that, but my career really has spanned the 80s and 90s and now into the 21st century and still going, you know, just the COVID has sort of shut things down, but they're picking up again, you know?
Yeah.
And also right before COVID, I'm in a band called Rodney and John with another great actor, John Hawkes.
Cool.
What kind of music?
Okay, can you guys hear the music in the background by any chance? I didn't know because I looked. Does this look familiar, Rodney?
That's from our first band called King Straggler.
King Stragglers with John Hawkes and Brentley Gore, right?
From California Dreamin'.
That's right. And you know what I've been doing the past couple days? I've been listening to this whole CD. And guess what? One of my favorite songs on this, and I want you to share with us who came up with the lyrics. And the song is "The Strangler's Lament."
The Stranger's Lament.
I'm sorry. I'm dyslexic. Incidentally, let me shout out to my dyslexia. The Stranger's Lament.
I am too. You're in good
lament.
Company.
Strangler's Lament.
But we could give it the Strangler's Lament today, since it's sort of a horror inspired day. John Hawkes wrote those lyrics.
I'm gonna put this song on. This song is so funny. Correct me. Nobody knows I got a big cock.
Nobody knows that I look better naked.
That's right. His lyrics crack me up.
Nobody knows that I'm sweet.
It's
nobody
catchy
knows
too.
I cried sappy movies. Nobody knows that our food is cheap. Nobody knows. I'm alive.
It's a good tune, isn't it?
Cheers to John.
Cheers.
John and I now have a band called Rodney and John.
Mm-hmm.
And you could find the record on, what is that? I'm so
Spotify.
Apple,
iTunes.
I don't think so. Maybe you could. I don't know. I'm really at a technological disadvantage.
No, no worries. But there's so if it's
where you can go and buy music. Is it Bandcamp? If you Rodney and John music, right before COVID, we had written a play called Rodney and John and the Meaning of Life, and our mm-hmm. first weekend had sold out, and my wife and I were doing about 8 shows a month, 4 music shows and 4 comedy shows every week, mm-hmm. producing the shows, and things were really moving along nicely. And then our opening day for the show was March 13th.
Nice.
Well, not nice, because that was the day they shut everything down in Los Angeles.
Oh, well, I thought you were getting to the horror movie.
I had Disneyland tickets on the 17th, so.
Because wasn't March 13th also Friday? Or do we
yes,
not talk about
Friday
other?
Yes, it was Friday 13th. No,
I know, that, I was gonna say, right. Or do we not talk about other horror movies?
No. I love all horror movies, especially horror movies from the Golden Age. You know.
Yeah. Do you remember that one horror movie, Rodney, that you did with Doe, our very own Doe? And did you? Can you believe the makeup that she did for the show tonight? Doesn't she look amazing?
Yes, she is unbelievable.
I know.
Thank you.
What movie did I do with Doe?
You did this one. You don't remember that one?
What was that?
I don't recognize it.
It's a great question. I blacked out.
It's a great question. And see, what I do is you have to, the chat. Those are for the chat. If you can name the correct movie, you win a prize. But you know, another thing is.
So many prizes on this show with no name, isn't it?
You know why? It's because I love giving prizes. But let's go back to A Nightmare on Elm Street. And
please. Can
you please tell us about this? Like, this was obviously on set, right?
It was.
And so can you just kind of, for us fans, can you kind of like walk us like what you were thinking in the moment and when they took this picture?
Well, I was just about to tell you that I was a huge fan of horror mm-hmm. In the 80s. I was a little heavy metal kid. I still got the hair to prove it. And so I saw Friday the 13th, Evil Dead, The Exorcist, Texas Chainsaw, the first Nightmare on Elm Street film. I saw them all in theaters when I was a teenager. When I had the audition for Nightmare on Elm Street 3. I was so excited just to get the opportunity to read for it. And of course my character didn't speak, so there wasn't any dialogue. The audition scene was my final scene where I scream and break all of the mirrors.
Right.
And so I was in heaven every single day I was on set. It took 6 weeks to shoot Nightmare on Elm Street 3. Mm-hmm. And Robert Englund could not have been more supportive or welcoming. What you see on screen with all the dream warriors, mm-hmm. That was really reflective of the family sort of vibe on set. And as evil as Robert Englund could ever be on set, he is equally kind off set. And so anytime you see me standing by Robert, especially behind the scenes, I was just incredibly grateful and incredibly proud to be there, and it was a dream come true.
And you know, when somebody found out that you were going to be on the show, they reached out to me and they wanted it, and they sent me this. They wanted to give you a shout out, and here it is.
Hello, Rodney Eastman. I hear you're doing the show with no name on Haps, and you're collaborating with FanQuest Live. Well, congratulations. I hope you have a good show. And Rodney, I'll be seeing you in your dreams.
WTF? Run, Rodney, run. Yikes.
Pretty great. Reverse shout out.
Reverse shout out. That's right. That's right.
Nice. I thought he was going to say he'll be seeing me in Dallas.
That's right.
Nice, sounds like.
That's yeah. right.
Dallas. What's happening in Dallas?
Oh my God. There's something happened. You want to share that with us, Rodney?
Do you want to share it?
You know what? What? We can both talk about it because, you know, it's the 16th annual Texas Fright Night weekend, and it is in
Frightmare, Texas
Frightmare weekend. And anybody who's spotted, if you look at the location on this show, that is where it's going to be. I put it in as the location. It's going to be at the Hyatt Regency and
DFW.
Check it out. It's in the location on this broadcast. And also, it's also the 35th anniversary of A Nightmare on Elm Street this year.
Yeah, it's hard to believe. It seems like only yesterday.
Yeah.
So that's the last weekend in April in Dallas. And Texas Frightmare is the biggest convention in the United States. I did once. I think probably about 10 years ago. And we're doing a full Nightmare on Elm Street 3 Dream Warriors reunion.
Nice.
All the Dream Warriors will be there. Ira Hayden, Ken Sagos, Penelope, Jennifer Rubin, Bradley Gregg, and also Robert Englund's going to be there.
Yes.
As well as Heather Langenkamp. So it's going to be a party, and these conventions are unbelievable. It's so great to be around the fans and just to see like how many generations that franchise has touched, you know.
Yes. Absolutely.
You see, I've met groups, grandmothers, mothers, and their kids. You know, all three of them at my table. And maybe it sounds, you know, cheesy or whatever, but it's really touching to meet the fans. And it's funny, I got to tell you, for many years, I was embarrassed that Nightmare on Elm Street was the most recognizable thing on my resume. You mentioned a lot of TV shows, and you know, I've done a lot of great stuff. I'm proud of all of it, but it wasn't until I started doing conventions that I realized that being in any of the Nightmare movies was a real honor, you know, and that it's a different movie than, say, The Godfather, but it's kind of the equivalent, you know?
Right.
So I finally realized these days that I was so lucky to be in those movies. And now I'd like claim it with pride, you know?
Absolutely. It's like the Star Wars of horror movies, you know?
Yeah, for sure.
It's an honor to be into that series.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and it goes down. I mean, I still, you know, it's funny. I don't know if anybody else does this. Maybe I'm one of the horror movie dorks, but on Halloween, especially if I get caught on the door duty, and the door duty is you got to answer the door and give out candy. So not all the time, but sometimes I get caught doing that, and I will just put on horror movies and I'll just binge and watch movies like Nightmare on Elm Street, a Jason movie, you know, Michael Myers, these kind of movies. But they're, because even though I've seen them so many times, you just, I don't know. It's just like it, the Halloween gets you in the mood for those movies. And I think a lot of other people can relate to that. Speaking of horror movies, do you remember the one movie that all four of us did? Remember where
Another
you,
movie?
Yeah, Rodney and Doe were throwing things at Veda and I, because Veda and I don't
that
know.
Sounds like us.
Yeah, yeah, we'll check it out.
Hey! Oh!
I know. Wait, that was before I started working out. That was before I started working out.
My brain is still not the same from that impact.
No, are you? You're.
I guess I don't get to guess, do I?
Yeah, you get to guess.
Why not?
No.
Absolutely.
I'm going to leave it. I'm going to leave it for the. I have abundance, so I'm going to leave the prize.
Speaking of working out, you're a fellow. You work out, correct? You're into keeping in shape.
Oh, me?
Ryan, you.
I used to be better at it, but yeah, I think I'm in pretty good shape.
I think you are, because a lot of people don't know that on his resume as well is he used to be in a commercial. And I dug deep and I found him in a commercial back in the day, and check it out.
Wake up. Keep going.
Remember when you did that shoot?
I do, yeah. Yeah, that was, I did that one in Italy.
Yeah, that's when you had shorter hair. That's when you had shorter hair.
I did. That, but if you run it one more time, I'm actually the guy behind the guy.
Oh, are you?
Keep going.
Yeah, I'm the guy behind the guy.
That's a little more accurate.
It's a little bit more accurate. No, I like to have fun with these movie clips, and especially to get an idea of, like, you know, some of the horror movies or just some of the possibilities. Like, you know, when in the, you can attest to this, you know, you'll audition for certain roles and you might not get them all, you know, like the one role that you auditioned for Wolverine. I thought you should have had it, though. I thought you would have been made a better Wolverine. What do you think?
Yeah,
No?
Missed it by that much.
Just by that much. Just by that much.
They said I was too buff.
Too buff? Well, yeah. when they, but then you tried to slender down a little bit for them in the Terminator. Remember that?
I do. Yes. That's me right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, who is that guy? That really does look like me.
A little bit. Just a little bit. But on that note, do you know what we also like to do here on the show, Rodney?
What's that?
To introduce a new vegetable or fruit.
One that nobody's ever heard of.
Never happened.
Right.
I'm staring at it like, can I eat this, please? Just kidding.
This is going to be difficult.
I know. I'm very intrigued to see how Kruger Dough is going to handle this one. But so tonight's fruit or vegetable is your very own carrots, everybody. So why don't you get out your carrots? Do you have any carrots?
Okay.
I just so happen to have. Some carrots myself.
I feel like Bugs Bunny right
now. Oh, wow.
So I also found.
Am I supposed now? When do I eat?
You can eat whenever you want. This is the
whenever
segment
you want.
Of this is
Dive
the
in.
Eating the eating. Segment.
I don't eat carrots, by the way. But
you
for
don't?
You,
are you allergic?
I will do it. No, I.
Okay,
well,
good.
That's funny. That's what people say when they just don't like a food. I used to be allergic. I used to be such a finicky eater. I was allergic to everything.
Yes.
Allergic to all vegetables, and I'm still allergic to carrots. But
what
my
about
lovely
the different
wife,
colors of carrots?
Those are beautiful. Wow.
And they come with stems too. I picked these fresh out of the garden.
Good job, James.
My,
really?
Wow, my lovely wife is standing by with a EpiPen, so I'm going to go for it.
Okay.
All God right. bless her.
Mm. This one is the purple one.
Hey, wait a minute. Hey, that's pretty good.
You know, your taste buds change like every 7 years. Maybe
have you been missing out on carrots all this time?
I have.
Welcome.
Because I had horrible 1950s parents that any vegetable we were served was cooked to death.
Mm.
Like boiled?
Yeah, so many kids are put off by vegetables.
Yeah, terrible.
Boiled.
I love raw vegetables.
Raw vegetables are delicious.
I was never fed raw vegetables as a kid. You know? A salad was like some iceberg and a crouton, you know?
Yeah.
But this is actually not bad.
They're not bad.
They got the hummus out.
I have to have dip.
Oh my God.
And, did you grow your carrot dough?
Come here.
It's not the time
of
year.
Come here, baby.
Oh,
come on.
I don't even know.
Look at here's my baby.
Share your baby.
Oh,
is that Face?
Yeah. Face. He's been barking this whole time.
Aww. The name
wanted
is
to
Face?
Get on camera.
Yeah.
Yes, his name is Face.
Hi, Face.
Because he's a little model. Look at him.
I was just going to say, did you get that from the show 18?
He loves carrots. Here. He doesn't like carrots either.
No.
No.
See, some dogs like them, some don't.
He does. He just won't eat on camera. Hey.
He's got an exclusive contract. He can't eat them on camera. I gotcha.
So his name is Face. Yeah. He's got an exclusive with broccoli.
He's got an exclusive with broccoli. That one's good. That one's good.
Thank you. So
I'm drinking my carrot juice.
His name is Face.
Good. Mm. Hi, Face.
And my dog actually loves peas and broccoli. Like, Missy will try and like steal them from. Like, she will beg for peas and broccoli. That is so bizarre.
So we got him.
Sweet.
We adopted him from a family in Montebello. I went back to my roots for my dog.
Oh, nice.
And he was
Neil.
His name. Get down. Oh, now he wants a carrot. See, now that he's off camera, he wants
right?
it. There.
See?
He just
See?
Ate. Yeah. He won't eat on camera.
He read his contract well.
Yeah. But we went to adopt him, and his name was Ace. And we wanted to keep the name. Excuse me. We wanted to keep the name. We wanted to keep the sound, but rebrand him.
Right.
And so Angela was saying Mace, Bass, and then I just looked at him and he was so cute. I said, no, Face, look at that Face, we'll call him Face. And now he's back for more carrots.
Nice.
Come here.
It's a good dog.
Did you guys know that there are 10 benefits, health benefits to carrots?
Hit us with it.
Exactly. 10.
It improves your skin.
Yeah. Well, actually, that's the number one.
Mm-hmm.
The number one, it improves your skin. One that is, we all want. It boosts your immunity system.
Mm-hmm.
It improves kidney function.
Yes.
It's nice. Very high in antioxidants, and that's it reduces
incidences
of stroke.
Yes.
Now that's interesting in itself because I never thought a carrot can have such that ability for people that have strokes.
Great. For
what is it in it that does that?
It's got to be one of the.
A?
It might be the A.
Beta carotene.
Beta carotene. Yeah, probably. No pun intended there.
Yeah.
But like a lot of the fruits and vegetables that we've been showing, it's great for your eyes and it protects brain health. It also maintains a healthy heart. It's antibacterial and viral. And it improves liver function. And some of us need to improve our liver function, if you know what I'm saying.
Is that a margarita, James?
No. It's carrot juice. It's carrot juice.
Yeah. I wasn't shaming you. I was just asking. It's usually a margarita.
Here, eat it.
Thank you for the hearts, Mark.
Come on, face. You're making me sad.
Come on, face.
God.
All right, he's so not
cute.
Having it.
So cute.
But he's begging for
Good
it.
Job,
okay,
Neil.
Go. Get out of here. Jesus.
And that all is presented here on haps.co. The network of now.
It's all happening on haps.
Oh, my God. Tracy Bingham. Happening. Hello, Tracy. I can see you this week. Well, sort of.
Do you know what's
interesting? Hi, Tracy.
Do you know there's a thing we can do, right? And so one of you, I'm going to be in your ear.
Yes.
So what I'm going to – so this is what I'm doing. I'm going to put myself backstage, and then I'm going to bring up Tracy, and then one of you, I will be in your ear. So you let me know who that is. The one.
The lucky person.
Dun, da, da, dun, da, 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 dun. Not in my ear. Tracy. Excuse me, Tracy Bingham. Please report to HAPS. Tracy. Testing. This is suspicious. What is happening in this ecosystem?
Can anyone hear James?
Not in my ear.
I can hear him.
Oh, perfect. Then you're the winner of this.
You're the chosen
segment.
One.
I can hear you. Oh yeah, I can hear you.
Just awkwardly eating carrots. Crunch, crunch. I'm having trouble. I mean, it happens, you know. Don't sweat it. Just, you know, let's enjoy our snack. Tracy? I opened the wrong eye. Stand by. All right. Wild card. Sounds good. I'm going to say hello to the chat. One bless cat.
Hey, wild card.
And Sadie. I thought you said you were eating something. My effing phone.
Your effing phone.
Throw it against the wall, Tracy. Well, we love you. You know, it was me last week, and it's you this week. It's fine.
It's quite all right because it happens. We love you too, Tracy. And if you're having technical difficulties, it's quite all right. But let us know if you want to say hello to Rodney. But you know what? Since Tracy was just here, do you know what would be cool, Rodney?
What's that?
If down the road, you and Tracy decided to do a quiz game horror movie theme together. What do you say?
I would be totally down. I'm a big fan of Jeopardy.
Yeah. Yeah, right? You know, and who doesn't like to win prizes, right?
I love winning prizes.
I know. And speaking of prizes, you still have time to get into the queue and win a prize. Because at the end of the show, somebody's going to win a prize. So,
really?
Just saying. You got to be in the queue to win, though. You got to be in the queue
to win.
The end of this very show. This very show.
Stand by.
And stand by. And, oh, we're in the stripping
nice.
Segment of the show where we all feel that if you need to, you know, take some clothes off, you know, get a little more comfortable.
I feel a lot hipper now. I was wearing the geeky golf shirt, you know.
The geeky golf
you
shirt.
Get on this shirt on this show, you get all sides of Rodney.
But that's
yeah. This
that's
is musician vibes for sure.
Yes. And you are definitely a musician, and we love that about you. You know,
thank you.
Because you're multifaceted. I mean, you're the acting, the musician aspect, little comedic, you know, thing. Obviously, you can model. We saw that. Woo.
And also, artist. My wife and I have a. You can follow us, please, on Instagram. We have a business where we frame antique prints.
Oh, nice.
Something that we put together during COVID times. And we do different series. And right now we're working on from the Library of Natural History. This is the first zoological compendium in over 6 volumes. that was really published in the United States, all printed in 1910. And you could follow. Oh, look, here's one right here.
Yeah, show us. So, because also, if they want to follow you on Instagram, is it the one that's with your wife, or is it your Rodney Eastman Instagram? Which is the one you want to direct
Eastman
them to?
Rodney Eastman
is the one you Rodney want to direct Eastman. Them to. Rodney yeah. Eastman. Mm-hmm.
And right, then cool. also the thing I was just talking about is Deep Cuts, and that's Deep _ and Cuts with a K.
Nice.
That's the frame one, right?
That's yes. That's our art. That's our art site.
Okay.
But I like that's got the horror theme into it too, right? Deep cuts.
That's right. Deep cuts of history. Cutting straight to the heart of history.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah. I like that. Very cool. Very cool.
Deep cuts. Deep cuts is what I need. A deep haircut.
A deep haircut.
we have the same hairstyle, you and I.
Yeah.
Mm. I haven't cut my hair since 2019.
Well, yeah, me neither, I don't think.
Just keep it going. Why not?
I have the same hairstyle as Freddy Krueger. You know, we both share the same hairstyle, too.
Nice. That's right. Nice. I'm so excited to see him in April.
That's going to be a good time.
I really love Robert. And Robert really loves my wife. It's a little uncomfortable. But what's more uncomfortable is how much my wife loves Robert. I was so excited when I introduced them, and now I'm afraid to leave them in a room together.
Well, what are you gonna do?
He's a charming bastard.
Right? He's waiting for you to go to sleep, Rodney.
Yeah,
Rodney,
no kidding.
Isn't it past your bedtime? Don't worry, I'll stay up with your wife.
we haven't got the invitation to come up to a suite and have a drink after the convention yet, so I think we're safe.
All right, cool.
Could still That's definitely awesome.
There's still time.
There's yes. still time.
Usually those invitations come last minute.
That's true.
From my experience.
You know, Tracy does want to say she's going to try one more time to see if she can get up here, because I think she wants to say hello to you, Rodney.
Okay.
So let's see if we can get her up here one more time. But if there's anything else you want to promote, and thank you so much for being here. I mean.
Oh, thank you for having me. And I'm so sorry I was late.
No worries. But, no. We're doing in the future is starting next week, next Tuesday, we're bumping it to our new time, which is going to be 8:00 Central, 9:00 Eastern, and 6:00 Pacific. So going
Perfect.
Forward, yes, going forward, and especially to help out all the West Coast fans and celebrities. 6:00 is a lot easier to get off that highway, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, for sure. And I would love to come back anytime.
We would love to have you.
A recurring guest.
Absolutely. Yeah, anytime. We'd love to have you. Yeah.
This is
yeah.
a good time. And you reintroduced me to carrots. Like,
what? But you what know
else,
what though, Rodney?
What
That's
there?
Monumental the next, in itself,
yeah, and
I think.
The next time though is going to be a different fruit or vegetable. So
Great.
Who knows what it will be next time. You never know.
We'll run
Eat something
again.
I don't like since I won't be here. How about that?
Well, and, the next time he's on, won't necessarily be next week. It'll be.
Oh, I'm
future.
Trying to get him to fill in for me next week.
Ah.
Moving on.
Anytime.
You can take my spot next week. How about that?
Like I say, we have the same hairstyle. So
yeah,
that's
it's
right.
much
you better
know
lighting.
The difference.
Yeah, oh, you know what? We can have Joe help you with your makeup, and then maybe you can look exactly like
Ada.
Why
don't you just fly on over to
Excellent.
And we won't even be able to tell.
and I just want to say again, I really want to promote Texas Frightmare Weekend. Yes. Last weekend of April, and that's at the Hyatt Regency DFW. This is amazing. The hotel is actually on top of a terminal. It's not a hotel near the airport. It is actually inside the airport.
Isn't
that
crazy?
I've seen hotels like that.
So yeah, it's amazing. I'm so
it's
excited.
It's weird, but it's cool.
And it's so cool. I love planes and the windows face out onto the runways, and you get to watch the planes take off.
Duty free shopping for breakfast, maybe.
Incredible. And I don't know if you noticed, but I have a problem with being on time, and I will definitely not be late to my flight.
Right.
Good.
Good. It's like just... right. It's like they. Do they have security like in the lobby of the hotel? That would be ideal, right? You just
hit up the concierge situation.
The concierge could just stand in line for you. I'm really excited to see what's there.
Yeah, as soon as you open the door, they put them right in the scanner and they go right on the plane.
I can't believe it. And I got 2 round trip tickets to Dallas from Los Angeles for $260. Unbelievable.
Nice.
Oh wow. Now, two travel, tickets for $260. Damn.
Yes.
When you travel, do you bring Face with you, or do you have somebody babysit him?
We live in a really great building. I've lived all over Los Angeles, and I've lived in this building for almost, built in 1917. I've lived in this building for going on 10 years. And the manager just knows how to pick the right people. It's the most neighborly building I've ever lived in. And anyone that lives here will take care of our animals. So it's pretty great. We all take care of each other's
1917.
Pets.
My old building in LA was built in 1917.
Oh, yeah. Remember that? Wow.
It was downtown.
Same haircut, same building age. Hmm.
Well, I'm not going to say the building, but there are a lot.
No, but Veda, share that. Wasn't it on like an old tour like route?
No. That was my Victorian house. This was the Hellman building downtown.
The Victorian house? Was that by USC?
No.
Oh, okay.
No, that wasn't in LA.
I thought because that was like one of those tours. Because I've been on one of those. You guys ever do those haunted guided tours? I've never been on one. I just went by my house all the time. South Carolina.
I love Charleston.
Are you kidding me? My wife and I, we want to probably maybe retire there and get a vacation home at least.
Nice. Love
it. It's beautiful. Yeah.
Yeah.
I love that area. The history, it's like Savannah, Georgia too. I love that.
Georgia's
pretty. Yeah.
I've been really lucky. I've been fortunate. Thanks for bringing up my IMDb. But I've been able to travel all over the world, through my career. It's just, I would say that's the biggest payoff I've experienced.
Right.
And it's so great to meet you guys.
Absolutely. And that's,
you too.
That's one of the wonderful things that I think a lot of us love about HAPS is the community, because there's a lot of amazing people that not only broadcast, but are also here in the chat.
Well, it's all happening on HAPS.
That's right, because
it's
the network
all
now.
Happening, Rodney. You're right.
I know. It exactly is.
Leslie wants to know what your favorite place to visit is, Rodney.
Yes. Can we, Hawaii.
Veda,
can you look at the chat a little bit? Because I'm seeing some other stuff. I can't see it.
That was the question for Rodney, and then I wanted to know too. What do you like Maui the best? What's your favorite?
I like Oahu. I have friends there. I used to go every year. Unfortunately, one of my friends passed away, but I still have a old high school friend there, and I love Oahu because if you need to get your city dose in, you could just go down to Waikiki, and Chinatown is really great. And then if you it's like at the bottom of the hill where I stay, if you turn right, you're in Waikiki in 10 minutes. And if you turn left, you're out by Hanama Bay in 10 minutes. I just love Oahu because it's got,
everything.
All things.
Yeah.
My dream is to retire and buy like a 30-foot sailboat and just spend the rest of my life traveling around the world.
Cool.
That would be
getting
awesome.
Close. I just got to convince my wife to join me.
Well, that guy, your friend, he can maybe entertain her if you want to go sailing.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
He was always That's right.
But you know what it is? My wife's the same way. She gets scared of the ocean unless it's a certain size boat. So you might be able to persuade your wife if the size of the boat is right, right? Can't be on some small boat.
No. And 30-foot boat is pretty comfortable.
Yeah.
And actually, she really hated the ocean. And I took her to Hawaii 2 years ago. And by the end of our 10 days there, she was swimming with me underwater in that beautiful, clear ocean. And at the beginning, the first day we were there, I tried to get her to go in some water that was literally about a foot deep. And she finally waded in. And she said, "Oh, no, the water is too wet."
Is she an air sign?
You know, I hate when that happens, when the water's too wet. I hate that.
Yeah, it was too wet for her. But by the end of the trip, it was like a scene out of Splash. We were swimming around together underwater. It was pretty beautiful.
That's pretty cool.
Amazing. I'm a lucky man.
Yes, you are a lucky man. And you know, before we go, you know, we have to close out the fan quest live so that we can see
who
our lucky winner is. So is everybody in the chat ready?
I hope so.
I hope you are. You know what? I'm going to show you. Let's see how this works.
Who wants it the most?
Who wants it the most? That's right. That's right. Who wants it the most? So.
Suspense is killing me.
Suspense is killing me.
That's a drum roll.
Oh, that sounds great. Please. Do you drum?
I do.
See this?
Cool. I can hear the rhythm in your body.
Succession. It ended successfully. End of session.
The moment is approaching. Get ready.
All right.
Guys.
So you know what that means?
What does that mean?
You should get a pop-up notification if you were the winner. So if you won, you should get a pop-up notification. And if you are in the chat, let us know you won.
I won.
Are you kidding me?
I don't think I'm supposed to win, though. And I never win anything. But have really powerful manifesting skills. So I'm sorry that I asked that question.
That is hilarious.
Wow, it's hilarious. It's fixed.
I'm sorry, my background blur. It says you have won the daily free play. Now it feels rigged, guys.
I know, but you know, no, guys, we thought that might happen. So what we're going to do is we're going to roll over her, that prize into the next GF show.
Like invade his face.
Well, I'm done with that show with no name then. I won't be here next week.
It's totally rigged. It's totally rigged. It's totally rigged.
It's the last you see me on this program.
I know. No, we thought about that because we wanted to get in the queue and help promote it.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you so much.
But since we're on the show, we don't want people to think it's rigged and we don't want there to be, you know, any conflict of interest. So what we decided, if one of us on the broadcast were to win, and I can't believe it did happen, Beta won, that we're going to roll. She's such a good manifester. Just goes to show.
I can't help that.
Manifestation is real,
work.
Everybody. Manifestation is real, everybody. So we anticipated this as that if this was an option, it would happen. That the prize is we're gonna roll it over into next week. So the prize is gonna be double for next week. Okay. So
great.
Instead of a $25 gift card to your phone, either Android or Apple, next week, it's going to be $50, everybody.
I mean, I'm moving.
Listen to
Wild
Card.
So, but you got to be in the queue.
Is saying in the chat, wait. It said, Wild Card said the winner is still out there. That was the daily free play.
Oh, that was a daily free play.
They did not win?
Just kidding. Wow. That was my dose of karma served up.
Oh, was it? Winner is still out there. All right.
Oh.
Wait a minute.
Okay.
If the winner is out there, where are you in the chat?
It's probably Mark Gage. He's probably asleep.
Mark Gage. Where are you? All right. Well, you know what? If the winner is not in the chat and they won, they will know and they will get a notification and we'll know who they are. And
it's me again.
Beta.
What?
What are you doing? What are you doing? Beta, why do you keep winning all our
stuff? Stop manifesting.
Stop manifesting for 1 second. For 1 second, Beta. For 1 second.
Give me all the dark energy.
No, but you know what? I want to thank everybody for being here. And it is that time to say goodbye.
Closing time.
And what we like to do, Rodney, before we go, is we like to say goodbye with a little bit of Andre Bocelli. So take in, let it flow through you, Rodney. Let it flow through you.
And Doe if you know sings it, this song really well, by the way.
Oh, Doe. I'm listening.
Sorry, Doe.
Sorry, Doe. Please.
No, I can't sing.
Share. No?
No, sorry.
I didn't mean to right now.
You know you can sing it.
Shh.
Come on. But it is time to say goodbye.
Peace out.
Time to say goodbye.
Look at Dose Peace.
I want to thank everybody in the chat for participating. I want to thank
Dankeschön.
The beautiful Beta Ashley.
Oh.
The amazing shapeshifter, the one and only Doe, Vegan Doe.
Thank you.
Look
for
at that.
Me.
I
Doe,
mean,
you
that
look
is the
amazing.
Most beautiful
oh, thank you so
Freddy
much.
Krueger you I've ever seen great. In my life. But the special guest, of course, Rodney Eastman.
Rodney.
Check him out.
Sorry.
Check out his Instagram. And if you get a chance to go to Texas in
Texas
April,
Frightmare,
the
you
16th
just gotta get yourself to the
annual
airport
Texas
and
Frightmare
there.
Weekend. And also the 35th anniversary of A Nightmare on Elm Street. You all have a blessed night. Tune in next Tuesday night. We'll have another special guest. And our new time slot is 8 Central, 9 Eastern, and 6 Pacific. Thanks again. Good night, Face.
Bye, Face.
You can eat carrots, Face. You're off camera. But it is time to say goodbye. Love you all. Take care, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye, guys.
Good night.
That was great. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.